Assalamu alaikum LTIT here. Your Oracle support from Bangladesh, and welcome to Lean's Tech on YouTube. Thank you so much for watching. If you're new to this channel, please hit that subscribe button and hit that bell icon for notification of our next one. Because we are dedicated to making more videos on Oracle Database and Oracle Application Express. Today, we are going to show you a great solution for configuring SQL Developer with Oracle Database 19c on Windows 10 64-bit. It's a very easy process. Before going to configure Oracle SQL Developer, you need to install Oracle Database. We install Oracle 19c as a database already. Now, we are going to configure Oracle SQL Developer. Before configuring Oracle SQL Developer, download the software from the Oracle SQL Developer download page. This is the link for downloading the software. The link is given in the video description. Or go to your internet browser and search in Oracle SQL Developer download. You will have to sign into the Oracle account before starting to download the software. If you already have an account on Oracle's website, that's good. If not, then create one. It's free for you. Let's log in with my Oracle account. So once you sign in, it will automatically start downloading for you. Very good. Our download has been completed successfully. It's portable software. That means you don't need to install it. You can just simply run it. But it's advisable for you to copy the software into your C drive on your PC. So, now we will unzip our downloaded software. We no longer need this folder. We can delete it if we want. Now, we can rename it. And let's go inside this software. Here, we can see sqldeveloper.x file. Now, right-click on this one from here, and then select Run as Administrator. Or, right-click on this one. Then go to Send to, and then select Desktop, Create Shortcut. Now, right-click on this one from here, and then select Run as Administrator. Skip, Confirm Import Preferences, by clicking No. And then click OK for Oracle Usage Tracking. You see, here, automatically detected database connections. If you want to connect from here, go to your pluggable database named ORCLPDB. Just click here, enter your pluggable database name as HR for username, then enter password for this user named HR, and then click OK. Press Ctrl plus Enter. If you want to create a new connection from the New Connection option, just click on the green plus icon. Enter name for the connection name as you like. We provide My New Connection for the name. Select a color for this connection from the color option, it's optional. Authentication type, default. Now enter a value in the username field. Enter the username of the user you want to connect with. Remember, before connecting to any pluggable database user, that user must be unlocked. Username, HR. Role, default. Password for HR user. If you want to save this user's password for subsequent connection, check Save Password option. Now select the connection type from the list. Here we want to connect our pluggable database using TNS entry. So, we will select TNS as connection type. Network alias. Now select net underscore service underscore name from the network alias list. Here, we need to select a network alias using which we can connect to our HR user. So, we will select ORCLPDB as network alias. After that, just it will be better for a new connection. Click on test button for testing whether your provided information is correct or not. If something is wrong, then we will get a red color error message. But here, we got a message named success. Now click on the save button, if you want to save your connection in the connection navigator. Everything is fine. Now just click on the connect button for establishing your desired connection. Well done. Our desired connection has been established. That's it for now. Thank you so much. To lead a happy, healthy, and successful life.